The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have been at the center of huge controversy this week, as it emerged the royals took 4 private jets in just 11 days, to travel to Ibiza for Meghan's 38th birthday and then to Nice a couple of days afterwards. Critics argue that the couple's actions contradict their public stance on climate change, given aviation is one of the world's major polluters and responsible for more than 2% of global emissions. The environmental footprint of a private jet is also much greater than that of a commercial plane. Yesterday, Sir Elton John defended the couple, revealing he had paid for them and their son, Archie, to maintain a high level of much-needed protection. The singer wrote on Twitter that he had made sure the flight was carbon neutral by making the appropriate contribution to a carbon footprint fund. He wrote, "I am deeply distressed by today's distorted and malicious account in the press surrounding the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's private stay at my home in Nice last week. Prince Harry's mother, Diana Princess of Wales, was one of my dearest friends. I feel a profound sense of obligation to protect Harry and his family from the unnecessary press intrusion that contributed to Diana's untimely death. After a hectic year continuing their hard work and dedication to charity, David and I wanted the young family to have a private holiday inside the safety and tranquility of our home. To maintain a high level of much-needed protection, we provided them with a private jet flight." As the row among royal watchers continues, a 2013 report by the Daily Express reveals that Kate Middleton traveled with her 6-month-old baby, Prince George, on a commercial flight. The second in line to the throne and the Duchess flew to St. Lucia on a British Airways flight. They then reached the private island of Mustaki with a jet, the only way to get to the secluded paradise. The mother and son were greeted by Kate's parents Michael and Carol Middleton, as well as her sister Pippa and brother James for the family's annual trip to the island, which coincided with Carol's 59th birthday. Prince George reportedly behaved very well during the long-haul flight and was accompanied by 3 royal bodyguards on the scheduled 747 jumbo jet journey. Even for long-haul journey, the Duchess of Sussex preferred traveling to and from the US on a private jet. Meghan traveled to New York for her baby shower in February. It reportedly cost £200,000 each way. The Duchess is believed to have traveled home on the Gulfstream G450 plane and landed at Farnborough Airport. Private jets usually carry fewer passengers than commercial planes, meaning they burn much more fuel per person per hour. Meghan and Harry have previously spoken about the importance of tackling climate change. In a post on the @Sussex Royal Instagram page last month, Harry wrote, "Environmental damage has been treated as a necessary byproduct of economic growth. Only now are we starting to notice and understand the damage that we've been causing. With nearly 7.7 billion people inhabiting this earth, every choice, every footprint, every action makes a difference." However, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are not the only royals who has left a massive carbon footprint this year. Last month, the Sovereign Grant Report was published for 2019 and revealed a massive increase in the royal family's CO2 emissions. According to the report, the royal CO2 emissions went up from 1,687 in 2018 to 3,344 in 2019, a staggering 98.22% increase. Buckingham Palace have defended the report, saying foreign travel on behalf of the government was responsible for the rise. Prince William has toured the Middle East while Harry and Meghan visited Australia, New Zealand, Fiji, and Tonga. 3 official trips were also undertaken by Prince Charles, who visited the Caribbean, Africa, Greece, and France. According to Sovereign Grant reports, more than 3,200 official engagements across the UK and overseas were undertaken by members of the royal family in 2018 to 2019. Reflecting on the year 2018 to 2019, the Keeper of the Privy Purse, Sir Michael Stevens, said, "The year under review has been another busy period for the royal household, with the Queen undertaking 140 official engagements in the United Kingdom, including the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting at Buckingham Palace and the visit of the President of the United States to Windsor. In addition, the program of other members of the royal family who support the Queen helped the royal family deliver over 3,200 official engagements across the UK and overseas."